The police, they decide to drag and tase a family dog. All right, let's put the pictures up full mass. Very sad. In Lodi, California, a family's beloved dog is now dead after he was repeatedly tased and dragged by the police. This was on the afternoon of January 24th. His name was Enzo, and the 2-year-old Husky was running free because a door was accidentally left unlatched at his home, allowing him to run around. Witnesses uploaded the video to social media sites and has gone viral, which shows officers approaching Enzo using a taser. The video shows the dog falling before returning to his feet after the first tase and then being tased a second time. At that point, an animal services officer was able to loop the snare pole around the dog's neck. The dog is then dragged to the animal services truck. Let's put up the individuals involved. Just, you know, their only way to handle it, according to them. The individuals identified as being involved in the death of this family pet are officers Timothy Ivy, Chris Delgado, and animal control officer Jordan Krenich. Police said the dog chased a family into their home and then tried to attack their dog on Sandpiper Circle. Then later became aggressive toward 3 bystanders on Finch Run. However, witnesses said none of that ever happened. They said none of that, whatever the police are saying, that just never happened. Describing Enzo as a very friendly dog. Enzo's owners, let's put up Anna Marquez. Anna and Aline Galano said the dog has never shown aggression and was not acting vicious on that Tuesday. The police said in a statement, the taser is designed as a less lethal option that was used by our officer in an attempt to stun and temporarily incapacitate the dog so that our animal services officer could safely get it under control. It is unfortunate, and we are saddened by the outcome of this incident. We understand the public outcry regarding the video footage that has been posted on social media. However, we would like to remind everyone that this is only a small portion of the overall incident. Don't you find it ironic that the same statement they would have had if they shot an unarmed black man is the same statement they have for unarmed dog? Let's put up the chief. Buck stops with him. He's the guy who is allegedly in charge. Chief Sierra Brucia runs the police department, Lodi Police Department. As it stands right now, no additional statement has come from the department. Let's put up the GoFundMe. All right, you would like to donate? There you go. It's an opportunity to do so and engage in a thoughtful way. So this happened. Why? Why? Why was that their only way to deal with the situation? It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Okay, there's a friendly dog and the dog is loose. All the witnesses said it was a friendly dog. None of this happened that you're saying happened. So why engage in that manner? All right, Wosny, thoughts here.
It's almost as if there's a playbook, right? Wow. Whenever these guys misbehave, they know what to go to, they know what to say, they know who exactly who is gonna back them up. This is just how they operate. It's quite obvious that this is the play, Dr. Richey. You come up with a false statement. You tell people like, oh, it was a mistake, or oh, it was, you know, the dog was attacking me, or oh, I felt in danger for my life. Or it's obvious. They use it at every single turn. It's, you know, covering your you know what at every single turn. And again, they know that their superiors are gonna back their moves, no matter how flavorful flagrantly they flout the rules. And so, you know, there's nothing surprising here. And of course, it's somebody's family dog. Like, these dogs provide all kinds of companionship for folks. People have genuine love and compassion for their dogs. And to have your dog die this senselessly and recklessly is unfortunate.